Hey, welcome back to the Ready State. We're talking part two of our mobilize at the position of restriction, which is the idea of trying to give context to the body's parts and movements while we're mobilizing. So if we're trying to improve a specific position, it's less press and guess and hey, let's get the body into a shape and a closer position to what we're trying to change. So classically, anytime where we can get a mashup and get more work done, we love that, right? Simplify the system. So one of the things that we are huge fans of course, is doing good old-fashioned lockouts. And look what's happening when I do this lockout, right? This lockout is as much about coordination for us and dealing with the stiffness in the hamstring as any other thing. So I can go and do these end range, contract, relax, hold, relax, try to address maybe more muscular system. So I'm putting some tension in, there's some features of the brain that allow the musculature to relax and go a little bit further. If I have a link tension issue, right, where my brain has set the musculature at a shorter position, for lack of a better phrase. But also one of the things we love is that this is a way of teaching the quadriceps to work against stiffness in the hamstrings. Oftentimes when we see people lock out a stiff deadlift, and then all of a sudden we start to see sewing machine leg, you know what I'm talking about? Some of that is your brain doesn't know how to fire those quads against stiff hamstrings. Your hamstrings are working, and then you start to get this sewing machine leg. And so what we do is we like to see that the quadriceps go on against these stiff hamstrings, and we teach the brain to be able to have that coordination. Also, it teaches us that at the end range, we are actually getting the leg straight, which is the full range. So if I'm working on trying to mobilize these tissues and I'm stuck half range, I'm not really working at the limits of my position. Okay, of course we can move this around back and forth, but look what's happening here. I'm able to load my knee first, this is the load, and then using my leg as the tensioner. So remember, your tissues work in a way that we call the load order sequence principle, or load ordering, which means the tissues that are loaded first in range are loaded maximally in range. So if I want to smoke and load the knee and the tissues further, I'll position these tissues first and then apply the tensioner later on. And I'm like, oh, I feel it behind my knee. But if I want to load the hamstring and the hip, I need to move the hip and the hamstring first, then load the leg. And all of a sudden you're like, okay, I feel that differently here. Again, that's how your nerves work. That's how your muscles work. That's why even how you come forward on the rowing machine matters. So what's nice now is that if I'm trying to improve this end range position, I'm actually not going to be stuck in this long lever shape why just folding forward or only doing leg lockouts sometimes doesn't get me what I'm after. If I'm doing long sitting position, in this position, I'm able to bias these tissues first and then apply this load, and then I can do all kinds of lockouts and all that, all the things that are good. Now, check this out. We can add in a little band distraction here. So now what we've got going on is that this band is gonna bias these tissues even further and more closely at the hip here. So what's happening now is that I'm putting even in a larger load, more proximal to the hip. This gives me better access to these tissues. Because if I'm looking at the system, look at how thin my knee-hamstring relationship is. It's pinche. But up here, it's gonna take a lot more load simply because my glutes and hamstrings and hip caps are more mighty than what's going down near the knee. This also helps us to have the hip obey the hip rule of flexion, where I have I've got some actual roll, slide, and glide going on in that hip. So suddenly, when I do this action now, this combined, add a band to my classic hamstring lockouts, now I'm really cooking. I'm mobilizing to the position of restriction. I'm able to bias the knee first, get these lockouts in, and I'm getting triple bang for the buck, which is always the game. So now, again, I can be doing my contract, relax, neuromuscular drives. I can be working on just tissue stiffness, right? Intramuscular stiffness. I can be working on my coordination and potentially a little hip mobilization at the same time. What we're talking about? What is your body supposed to do? What are you trying to do to change that specific position? Short lever hip flexion looks a lot like squatting. See you guys next time.